Guys, I'm coming out to see the alligator.
Yeah, you got to get out here, too. You know why? Because this weekend you can get some hands-on experience with all things creepy, crawly, and reptile-y. We're talking about the Sacramento Reptile Show.
And you can go to the
reptile show. Yeah, you can. Exactly. At the Sacramento Convention Center this weekend.
It's the largest exhibition of its kind in Northern California. Jeremy Epstein and some of his...
How are you guys?
We're doing great. Some of your little friends have joined us today.
Yeah, this is a leucistic Texas rat snake, about 7 feet long. And the blue eyes, which makes her a little different than an albino. The albinos have the red eyes, but the leucistics have the blue eyes. And she's one of our education snakes, and we take the different events with us and bring out as a hands-on tool.
So she's obviously very docile. And here you've got an interesting-looking brooch.
Yeah, this is a clownagama. This is there's two different sets of reptiles that are seen at the show, and there's the ones that make great pets, and there's ones that don't make great pets, which you guys are going to see in just a sec. And the clownagama is a small lizard, does really well with children, nice bright yellow color, and very fun little sweet little lizard.
Do they bite? Can I feel him?
Oh, yeah. No, they don't bite,
but
yes,
bite.
You can feel him, yeah.
He is very spiny.
On the other hand, your other friend back here, Izod.
It's part of our not good pet club.
Now, you, what's your name?
My name's Gabe Kirsch. I'm with Wild Things.
Gabe, thank you for coming out for us.
Absolutely.
He's obviously pretty docile. What's the process of bonding with an alligator?
Well, bonding is, you know, it's me sharing my love with him. And it's one-directional bonding here. You know, Izod's been handled for about 24 years in a school outreach program, traveling to school groups and speaking to school children.
Can we pet him?
Absolutely.
Okay. You got his head there, right?
Yes, I do.
Can you say crikey?
Crikey!
Wrong crocodilian.
Yeah, exactly. That's amazing.
Now, Izod will be there as part of our program. We're there talking about animals that should not be perceived as pets. We'll be at the SAC both days at the reptile show talking about animals that should be left alone in the wild.
You know, I bet, do you guys find that people do keep animals like this?
Huge problem in California and throughout North America in terms of people not being content with a dog or a cat as a pet and just ranging into this this strange world of illegal wildlife. Hmm. And so that's really our role there at the SAC Reptile Show has been really good about teaching people the differences between what should be perceived as an animal that can be comfortably housed and can be a wonderful addition to the family and teaching kids about caring for an animal as opposed to the animals that should not be there.
So when you guys were kids, were you just obsessed with stuff like this? Because, I mean, my three-year-old right now can't get enough of it.
Oh, yeah. I think that I've always been obsessed, and I think my poor sister suffered dramatically because of it. So
yeah. It's all worked out all right.
And over here you've got what appears to me to be a small Komodo dragon.
It's actually a black-throat monitor. It's an African monitor who was out walking around earlier. He's the one who ate the chicken for you on camera a little while ago.
Lovely.
Yeah, that was pleasant.
And that's another example of...
Thanks for that, by the way.
It can be a fun pet, but you're talking about a six-foot lizard.
Yeah.
That you got to be smart about what you take home.
Right place, right time.
Yeah.
Yeah. How many of these do you have at your house?
Oh, we've got a couple hundred animals.
Couple hundred. Yeah. You know what? What does he eat, or how much does he eat?
She eats big rats.
She eats.
So you have 3/4-pound rats, so... big ones, and she'll eat once every 10 days or so.
She is a constrictor, I'm assuming.
Well, all snakes constrict. She's not the true boa constrictor, but she definitely will squeeze her food.
Right on. Look at him.
Yeah.
That is amazing.
Oh, he's eyeing you, Teo.
Yeah, it reminds me of that Jergens commercial.
He looks hungry.
Got scaly skin. You know that one I'm talking about? They're always like, I'm pooped.
Does he have an itch? Is that what he's doing?
No.
No?
Is he itching?
Well, he looks like he's scratching his chin.
He's going for a walk.
He's going for a walk.
Now, can he really scoot if he gets... Oh, I got a snake almost on my arm.
Okay.
Any chance we could take him to our morning meeting?
Sure.
That's awesome.
We just need him for like 2 minutes, please. Well, it's great fun, and the reptile show is, of course, going on this week, and it runs Saturday and Sunday. Both days starts at 10 a.m. at the Sacramento Convention Center, so head on out there.
Go see it.